It is a victory for the petitioner Shayan Banerjee, who had filed the PIL in the Calcutta High Court regarding the Bhavanipur bipoles. What has the court said? And of course, it's a victory for you.
Yes, it's a victory for not only me, it's a victory for us, it's a victory for the peoples of Bengal. It's a clear message from the court that the entire bureaucrats of Bengal is now under the political scanner. You know, they are not there, discharge their function according to the constitution, but according to the interest of the political parties. Because the chief secretary wrote a letter to the election commission and urged the election commission to hold the election in Bhavanipur constituency. And he further stated that if Mamata Banerjee will not elect from the constituency, then there will be a constitutional crisis. And we have challenged the para 6 and para 7 of the said press note released by the Election Commission of India. We are not here to stay the election. We are here to point out the thing that the entire bureaucracy of Bengal is now under the scanner of the political party called Trinamool Congress, and the Chief Secretary's role, the question by the Honorable High Court. The Chief Secretary is not here to protect the interest of an individual. Chief Secretary cannot wrote a letter to the Election Commission and said that only hold the election in Bhavanipur just because Mamata Banerjee intends to elect a contest from the Bhavanipur. And that was our prayer. Our prayer was not that we want to stay the election. So there was no question of the stay in election. And it's obviously a victory for us. Because, you know, according to the theory of separation of power, the executive cannot interfere into the business of legislature. Who will be the chief minister? Who will be the minister? It is a pure legislative business. The chief secretary, being an executive, he cannot enter into such matter.
Another question I'm going to ask you. You are saying that there is para 6 and 7 of the press note of the Election Commission when they released the notification for the elections to be held. What was there in para 6 and 7 that you are talking about, which you feel was not necessary?
Para 6 and 7 wrote by a letter wrote by the Chief Secretary of our state to the Election Commission, and then the Election Commission under the para 6 and 7 is the press note. The press note is here, and he said that there will be a constitutional crisis if Mamata Banerjee will not win. Now our prayer is very clear that just few months back Trinamool Congress secured 200 plus seats in the election. The people's verdict or the opinions of the people is with the Trinamool Congress. So how can there be a question of the constitutional crisis? Yes, the individual crisis may be there, the crisis of Mamata Banerjee, but there was no question of constitutional crisis. There was no question of, constitutional vacuum. Because the Trinamool Congress have the 200 plus seats in their hand. Just because Mamata Banerjee wants to continue as a chief minister, the Chief Secretary cannot wrote a letter to the Election Commission and protect the interest of the proposed Trinamool Congress candidate called Mamata Banerjee and the Chief Minister.
But the Calcutta High Court has also said that who will bear the cost of the bipoles, because like you mentioned, there is a winning candidate, then there is Mamata Banerjee who is contesting after this winning candidate steps down. So what does the court say?
Exactly. No. The matter is still sub judice. Okay. The court fixed the date on 17, and court will hear the matter again. And is a bigger aspect of the case in the parliamentary democracy. It's your liberty that if you go through the qualifications, okay, if you have the qualification, then you can contest in the election. But the fact is, a sitting MLA was there whose name is Shobhandeep Chattopadhyay. He steps down, and then Mamata Banerjee comes, and she wants to elect. She wants to contest from the Bhavanipur. Now the question raised by the court that who will bear the election? You know,
cost.
Yes, obviously. Who will bear the cost? Because it's a democracy is a costly process. Okay, now who will bear the cost? The election commission generally bear the cost to hold the election. But elections after elections, by-elections are there. I am elected as an MLA and I have the people's opinion with me, people's verdict with me. And then I step down just because I want my party leader comes and contest from my seat. Then I will go to another seat and contest from there. No, it's a misuse of the public money.
A misuse of the public money, that is what a petitioner Shayan Banerjee says. With camera person Prabir Biswas, Prema Rajaman, Kolkata for India Today.